Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can generate a block RAM for your retro computer or for your FPGA project using the large language models, in, to be more precise, ChatGPT. So I'm asking to design a module in Verilog. I use Verilog because it's much easier to initialize the memory in Verilog from an external file. And I'm initializing this file with some content. And in the same time, I'm creating a wrapper, a VHDL wrapper, so I can plug this into a VHDL top-level file project. Why I'm using ChatGPT and I'm not using directly the tools, because all those memories, they are available in the IP catalog, because the code is a little bit more portable, so you're not getting locked into a certain vendor or architecture. Now, nothing is stopping you to actually use the tools like the IP library in Vivado. It's the same thing you get, it's the same result. But it's just another method, it's another way of doing things. I hope you enjoyed the video and let me know in the comments.
Right, so I have a prompt here and I'm going to start generating a RAM memory in Verilog. So, can you write a RAM memory of 32 kilobytes in Verilog? Okay, so we are getting this nice module here on the side. It seems to be correct at the first glance. So it has 15 lines of address for 32K. That's correct. Okay, let's try to initialize this from an external file. Can you add an initialization of the memory? Obviously misspell this. From an external hex file named from 16k dot hex. I think I have this file already created, but anyway, can you add an installation? Let's see how it's changing the code. Okay, so he added here an init from an external file. Okay. Now I'm going to ask something which probably is going to fail, but can you change the offset of the initialization to address so basically I'm saying that I want the init to start from on the bottom half. Actually, that's incorrect. That's what's the 2 of the power of, okay, it's let me calculate the address. Okay, 16384. So I want to start to put data in this starting from this address. I'm not sure if he's going to do this correctly, but let's see. So it's supposed to add here another parameter, which is the offset or the start address. I'm not sure if that clever, but yeah, it did. Okay, let's take this code. So we copy this. I go in Vivado where I have an empty project. I have nothing here. So let's create a file. So create design sources. Next, create file. I want a Verilog file, and I'll explain why I choose Verilog. What's the name of this module? It was RAM 32 KB. Let's call it the same. RAM underscore 32 KB. Local to the project. Okay. Finish. Okay. So he's going to create an empty file here, hopefully. I'm going to delete everything here and paste from. All right, so apparently it's the syntax is correct because there is this green dot here. So let's save this and let's synthesize. So while it's running, why I choose Verilog? I choose Verilog because it's much, much easier to initialize the content from an external file in Verilog. Because of those, you know, functions like read memh, which it's actually for reading from a hex file, from a text file with hex values, there is another read memb from binary. Okay, run implementation. It seems that actually has synthesized correctly. So that's the only reason why I choose Verilog, because my project is actually VHDL. And then I'll show you how to generate a wrapper for this and plug it into a VHDL with ChatGPT, of course, with AI, with large language model, to be more precise. So let's let him finish this. He's placing, running place, routing in a second. Okay. In the meantime, let's go to ChatGPT and ask to write a wrapper. Can you write a VHDL wrapper for this memory? So now he's supposed to write a VHDL implementation, which is instantiating this, I hope. Okay. Okay, so he actually created a module called entity wrapper. And this instance is declaring a component which matches the name of our Verilog component, and is instantiating this here. Of course, generating all the signals. And, yeah. Okay, so let's have a look. This has finished, so let's open this, the implemented, to see if it's actually landed on a block memory, because this is what we want. We want to use block memory. Okay. Okay, there are some. He's saying that there are some violation of the methodology, but it's actually complaining that he doesn't know how to assign the pins because there is no constraint file. Anyway, so let's see what we got. So we got those block ramps here, and we got those block ramps here. And if we want to see the routing resources, yeah, they're all connected to some IOs. With some IOs here. So definitely did the right job. So we got those, no synthesis errors or anything like that. Okay, anyway, so let's close this. Now, what we want, we got this VHDL wrapper. So let's copy the wrapper and let's create a VHDL file here. Add, create design resources, next, create file, VHDL this time. Let's call this file exactly the same like it's called by ChatGPT, which is what? RAM 32 KB wrapper. Okay. So RAM 32 KB wrapper. Okay. Finish. Entity name, that's correct. Architecture, blah, blah. Okay, so this is going to create an empty file. A VHDL empty file. I'm going to open it, select everything in this file because I don't need it, and paste what our friend ChatGPT generated. and save. So now in this file, it should be an instantiation of the other one. Okay, now you see the top level file is actually clever enough to change the top level file automatically. So he figured out, okay, if this is an instance, a child of this, this is supposed to be the top level. Anyway, let's try to synthesize this. So what we achieved here, we achieved two things. We generated a block memory that we initialized from an external hex file. Now, I previously created that file and I put it there in the right directory, so it doesn't complain, because it was complaining. If it's trying to access, okay, that's fine, run implementation. Obviously, nothing is changing because it's just a wrapper. So because this file is getting reference here, if you don't have that file in the working directory, it will complain. I created that file and I put it there. Now, you can create that file actually with ChatGPT as well, but that's for another video. So, yeah, it's running placement in a second, and it's all good. So, again, what we achieved, we generated a block memory, which we initialized from an external file, and we created a wrapper so we can use this in a VHDL main project. So why all the pulleys and ropes, and why we didn't just went VHDL directly? Because it's difficult to initialize in VHDL. It's the VHDL can open text files, but it's a bit more complicated than this. Now probably ChatGPT can do that, but anyway. So this is it. Okay, so it looks like we have no implementation error. Okay, coming back to ChatGPT, this kind of concludes our video. So we didn't write one line of code. We just asked for things, which I think is it's quite an achievement. And the code is very, very nicely written and nicely structured and with explanation, and you even get here some nice explanation. Well, I hope you learned something, and I'm sure you have questions like, why did we use this and we didn't use directly Vivado? If we were using Vivado as in the normal method of going here, IP, the code probably is not going to be that portable. This is quite portable. This is completely architecture independent. So this is getting synthesized and mapped by the tools to block RAM. If you go here and you add, it's going to be a little bit specific to that, so you're kind of locked into that part and to the vendor. You can use this code in Altera tool if you want, or in Lattice, or whatever other FPGA you may target. So I hope I see you in the next one, and I hope you enjoy the video.